Hi, if you like animals and art as much as I do, then today's activity is perfect. We're going to be doing Australian dot painting from our camp, The Wonderful World of Art, which explores art and cultures from all over the world. So of course, this activity comes from Australia, and it showcases some of Australia's really unique wildlife. So today, I'm going to be working with the silhouette of a kangaroo. This is available as a PDF for you to download right on our website. But you can also use any Australian animal, maybe a wombat or an echidna or any of your favorite animals. And if you want to mix things up, maybe you could even use the silhouette of your own dog or cat. But like I said, today I'm going to be using a kangaroo. So this is a painting activity that was originated by many of the Aboriginal peoples in Australia. And traditionally this used pigment from natural sources like maybe clay or berries, but today I'll be using traditional paint. So I've picked out some natural colors. I've got a really dark green, a red, a bright yellow, a tan, white, and blue that I'm going to use on the kangaroo. And we'll be filling in this silhouette with different dot patterns. And instead of using a paintbrush, I went out and I picked up some sticks from my yard. I chose a couple different sizes so I can get different circumferences in my dots. So to start with, I'm going to use the smaller stick and I'm just gonna dip that generously into my paint so I can get a big glob on the end and then just start putting patterns of dots in my kangaroo. To start, I'll put these big green dots here along the back of the kangaroo. So you can see that the dots aren't perfect, which is one of the things that I think makes this artwork so special. And as I'm starting to run out of paint, I'm gonna dip that stick back in my paint tray and continue all the way down until it finishes off in the tail. One of the other things I like to keep on hand for this activity is just a paper towel so I can wipe off the stick in between or if I wanna switch up colors. So I'm gonna change to that bright yellow and put a different pattern here in the center. Maybe some dots in a circle and then some more dots around it. But you can choose whatever pattern you would like. Maybe dots that form some stripes or other shapes. Let's see, I think I'm gonna switch over to that larger stick and dip that in the blue paint. And then start up here at the top and just put some really big blue circles up here. So you can see lots of different sizes, really adds variety to this activity. And you can do this until you've filled up your entire kangaroo. And like I said, you can choose all sorts of different patterns. Here's one that I was working on earlier. You see it's got lots of different dots in that, some that make different shapes, like a triangle, or maybe these concentric circles of dots here in the center to really create a unique shape and a unique pattern. Something that's different on this one is I've added a few symbols around the edges. So those are over here on my little chart. And these are traditional symbols that have been used in Aboriginal cultures. Some of my favorite ones are up here, the green arrows, and traditionally this was used to indicate kangaroo tracks. So I've put that on my kangaroo painting here, and it's like we're out in the outback tracking down the kangaroo, looking for those kangaroo tracks in the dust or in the dirt. And then our arches here mean people. So it's like we're out there really scouting them out and on the lookout for kangaroos. So this is an easy activity that you can do from home, just using some paint, some sticks, and a little bit of paper. And you can also edit it to make it any way that you want, doing animals that you're familiar with or that you know of at home. Thanks so much for joining us today. Be sure to check back real soon for additional activities and check out all of our online camps for YEP this summer. Thanks, everyone.